When I was looking at Donaldson filters as a possible replacement filter for my mower, it was quite annoying because they show you the filter, but they don't really show you how it works. Now, this Donaldson filter has the intake pointed downwards. They have this exact same filter with this sticking straight out. One thing they don't show you is that this turns on the end of the filter. So if you're going down to your carburetor like this, or if your carburetor is over here, or at an angle, or back over here, you can turn this. In here, you could install what they call a flow restriction gauge or whatever. It's just a little flow meter type thing that if this filter is getting plugged up, the engine is sucking on this too hard, it'll give you an orange or yellow or red indication. And if you look at this thing and it's still green, then you know your filter is still clean. I think the easiest way is to open it up once in a while and look at your filter. On this end, there's this, what I call a rubber duck thing. And as your pistons are going up and down in your engine, you're creating pulsation of air going through the air cleaner. And that is supposed to open and close this thing and expel any large or heavy debris that this has accumulated. You can open this thing up, and this is your filter. And you just kind of wiggle it out of there. This seals fairly tight on this nipple in here. Now, air comes in here and is caused to rotate around the outside here, which hopefully centrifugal force will knock out the larger bits and pieces. This piece goes in there in a similar fashion, and that debris is meant to fall down here at the bottom, and you have a slot that opens up to this rubber duck thing. Once the air comes in, it passes through this filter and then goes to your carburetor. One extra bit of protection is what's called a safety filter. And this safety filter plugs inside that hole. And then this goes over it. So as this filter is worn or possibly gets a small hole in it and allows some finer particulate matter to get past this, the safety filter would stop it and keep it from going into your carburetor. Nice idea. This is very, very tight. You shine a light through here and you can see this is a very fine filter. And this thing, goes around the outside. Anyway, trust me, that goes around the outside. It has these little teeth here. Those teeth will index into these two holes so that this filter can be mounted in different positions relative to your mounting plane. And then this is a rain hood that just mounts on here. It doesn't do anything except keep water from going directly in there. There's no filtering properties other than keeping leaves and large bits of material from going in there. So that's a little better explanation of how this works than what you will generally find on the internet.